The family of a woman killed in Brisbane by her estranged husband have spoken out about his controlling, abusive behaviour. Hannah Clarke died along with the couple's three children after New Zealander Rowan Baxter set their car alight. Kate Nicol Williams reports.
A strong and kind woman, a fierce protector of her children till the very end. That's how Hannah Clarke's family want her to be remembered after she was killed this week.
Never get over it.
Yeah.
Not my babies.
I personally can't process the event at all. It's just too painful for me to even try and think of how it happened.
They say Rowan Baxter ambushed his family when they were in the car, commending Hannah for giving information to police despite 90% burns to her body.
To the end, she fought to make sure if he survived, he got punished. Yep. Doing that to her babies. Yeah. She was so brave.
Yeah.
They never thought their son-in-law would kill his kids, but worried Hannah was at risk despite her protection order.
She said to me only last week, Mum, should I do a will? She said, what happens to my babies if he kills me?
Her mother sharing details of the manipulation Rowan used, playing the victim even the night before the tragedy.
He was on the phone to the children crying, and when the children hung up, she said to me, Mum, I feel so bad for him.
It started with controlling what she wore.
In hindsight, if only we could have seen and got her out of this situation earlier. And the problem was getting her out of the situation then drove him stronger and more to try and win and get Hannah back, get the children back.
Even Hannah, for a few years there, she said to me, I was thinking it wasn't abuse because he never hit me.
They said he tracked her movements, would take the children and turn off his phone and force her to have sex. If the house was messy, he wouldn't speak to Hannah for days.
Her eldest Aaliyah would cry to him, you know, please speak to Mum, like, you know, she hasn't done anything wrong.
The family urging others to notice the early signs of domestic abuse and take action before it's too late. Kate Nicol Williams, One News.